In the previous class, we have seen types of pollinations. First type is autogamy or self-pollination. Geitonogamy. Functionally cross-pollination, but genetically self-pollination. Xenogamy, cross-pollination. Or it is also called allogamy. Allo means different, gamy means fusion. Different plants are fused, different sex organs of different plants are fused. In autogamy or self-pollination, we have studied in the previous class that the characters are compulsorily a bisexual plant. Or bisexual flower should be there. Along with this, some other necessary conditions we have seen, that is synchrony between the male and female, release of the pollen and receptivity of the stigma. They should lie close to each other. They should be in same position. So various other conditions are there. Which assure self-pollination or autogamy. To understand this, we have studied in the last class, we have studied various types of flowers like chasmogamous flowers and cleistogamous flowers. Chasmogamous means opened flowers, cleistogamous unopened flowers. So autogamy or self-pollination is invariable in cleistogamous flowers, which are called unopened flowers, are closed flowers. So in closed flowers or unopened flowers or cleistogamous flowers, even though pollinators are not there, definitely without any other doubt, self-pollination occurs because they were always closed. There is no need of any other pollen grain to fall, will not land on the stigma because it is closed. So inside the flower, both male and female are there. They will definitely transfer the anther pollen from the anthers to the stigma, and the pollination will occur. Geitonogamy, we have seen, in between two flowers of the same plant, in between two flowers of the same plant, if the pollen transfers from the anthers to the stigma of another flower of the same, it is a cross pollination, but within the same plant, so genetically same, similar. Oh, functionally cross-pollination, but genetically self-pollination. Xenogamy or cross-pollination or allogamy. It shows that two different plants belong to the same species. Two different flowers belong to the same species. but plants are different. So when pollen grain falls or transferred from the anthers to the stigma of a different flower of another plant, both the plants should belong to the same species, plant A and plant B. So these are the three types of pollinations we have seen in the last previous class, and out of these generally they used to ask questions, which is advantageous and why it is advantageous, which is disadvantageous, why it is disadvantageous. In that, generally why autogamy is advantageous, advantageous out of many characters, continuity of species surely for many generations. So surely means this plant which is showing autogamy, it is not to wait for some other pollen grain to fall on it. For example, there is no other plant, male plant in that area, only female plant is there, for example. Under this condition, there is no pollination. So if autogamy is there, surely for many generations, it can continue its race. And always self-pollination, autogamy, results in homozygosity. Homozygosity means all the characters that are present in the plant, they are in homozygous state. Homozygous state you will study in genetics. Pure homozygous dominant, pure homozygous recessive, like that. Same characters can be retained. Retained for many generations. It means, for example, in this plant, which is showing self-pollination, if it is having good characters, the same good character can return for many generations. For example, what are the disadvantages of autogamy? Autogamy or self-pollination, disadvantages. No occurrence of new characters. It means self-pollination, auto, within the same plant, whatever characters are there, they will be goes on, retain the same character. It means if this plant is crossed with some other plant, this plant may be having different character, that plant may be having different characters, so two different characters, a new plant can be developed, produced. So here there is no characters which indicates no variations. Mainly the drawback or disadvantage of autogamy. Here, whenever self-pollination occurs for several generations, there is a possibility by continuous selfing, one day it results in some of the recessive characters present in the plant may express. Recessive character means undesirable character, unwanted character, bad character, which is called inbreeding, depression. So self-pollination for long generations results in inbreeding. Self-pollination means inbreeding within the autogamy. Inbreeding, depression, or appearance of recessive characters. Recessive character means unwanted characters or undesirable characters. So autogamy or self-pollination, it is having both advantageous characteristic features and also disadvantageous characteristic features. Geitonogamy, transfer of within the same plant. Xenogamy, between. CED general question, or at the end of PUC questions, how many types of, what is pollination and how many types of pollinations are there? What is autogamy? Write a short account. What is the difference between geitonogamy and autogamy? What is geitonogamy? What is the difference between geitonogamy and xenogamy? What is autogamy and xenogamy? Differentiate. So various questions are there. CET questions generally. In which of the following plants plant A and plant B? So they have given two plants or three plants or four plants. In which are the following plants, the number of flower to the plants is 1:1? One question. In which of the following plants, they will give some characters to the plant A, some characters of plant B, or by the understanding of your knowledge, the number of flower to the plants. So number of flowers and number of plants is 1:1. In which of the following, for example, in autogamy, one plant, one flower. So in autogamy, the ratio or the number of flowers to the plants is 1:1 plant, one flower. In geitonogamy, autogamy, one plant, one flower. In geitonogamy, the ratio is 1:2. One plant, two flowers. So in the plant A and plant B, they will give these characteristic features what we have already studied. Xenogamy, the ratio of plant to the flower or flower to the plant, two plants, two flowers. The number of, the ratio, we can ask like this, the ratio of flowers to the plants or plants to the flowers, 1:1, 1:2, 2:2. So 1:2. Again questions comes, under what conditions geitonogamy means, second type of question, geitonogamy means both the plants, both the flowers of the same plant may be bisexual or unisexual. One is male, one is female. They may ask questions. Oh, gutenogamy is a type of pollination that involves crossing of plants, crossing of two flowers, which are statement type of questions. Crossing of two flowers, which may be bisexual or unisexual male, unisexual female. So gutenogamy is possible. Gutenogamy is compulsory. Only gutenogamy is possible. Questions are there. Only gutenogamy. Under what conditions only gutenogamy is possible? When a flower with male and a flower with female. Under these conditions, both male and female flowers are present on the same plant, compulsorily gutenogamy is possible. And we cannot say that this plant, flower, gutenogamy, it can deceive pollinators from here. So multiple forms of questions are there, my dear students. There is a possibility of asking a neat question here. Number of plants, number of flowers, character, statement type of questions. Now, agents of pollination. So in the previous class, we have studied so many agents. A summary, we have given bats, birds, ants, snails. We have seen even snakes, animals. Basically, all the agents of pollination are classified into two types. Abiotic agents of pollination. Abiotic means non-living. Biotic agents means living. So the agents of pollination are broadly classified into two types, abiotic agents and biotic agents. Biotic agents are more common, are major. Abiotic agents are non-living agents, are very few, are less. There are two abiotic agents. Again, abiotic agents are classified into two types based upon their occurrence. Wind or air, it is a non-abiotic pollinating agent. Water, abiotic pollinating agent. Pollination through the wind is called anemophily. Anemophily means it is a type of pollination. The agent for this pollination or transfer of pollen from the anthers to the stigma is by wind or air. Anemophily. So there are two types of abiotic non-living agents of pollination. Among these two, wind and water, wind is the more common. More common. Water is rare pollinating agent. Pollination by water, as water as a abiotic agent for pollination. This pollination is called hydrophilic. So in the agents of pollination, abiotic and biotic. Abiotic non-living, very few. Among these, wind and water are prominent. Wind is more common. Out of the wind and water, wind is more common and water is rare. Wind pollination is called anemophily, whereas water pollination is called hydrophily. Biotic, more common, major biotic agents of pollination are animals. These animals, they include basically insects, bees, flies, so many. Wasps, moths, birds, bats, all these things comes under animals. Let us see agents of pollination, abiotic agents, non-living. First one, wind as a pollinating agent. Before we are going to study wind as a pollinating agent, we have to know the facts. Abiotic agents, which are nothing but non-living, whether wind or water. For example, wind pollinating. In wind pollination, what happens? Here is a plant, which is a female plant. Whenever a female plant is there, female flower is there, exposure here. And it has to show pollination by a male. It is a chance factor. Chance factor means chance of occurrence. Means female flower is here, female plant is here, and male plants may be somewhere there, or somewhere there, or somewhere there. And when it is releasing the pollen grain, it is uncertain that the pollen then may definitely come to the female flower here. So whenever a female flower is here, when male are there somewhere else, it is not accurately or certainly or definitely male pollen will come to female pollen by female sigma by wind. We cannot give any certainty, assurance. There is a chance. By chance, then by chance means here, when so many male plants are there, or so many male pollen are there in the air, if they were moving through the wind, called wind pollination, by chance, if any pollen may attach to the female flower, this is called chance of occurrence. So in this, during this, the concept is during this, maybe female flower is one. Female flower means pistil, ovary, ovule is one, and pollen may be many. Why so many pollen has to come? They will be going that side, this side. By chance they were moving by this side, there is a chance of pollination, wind pollination. So for this, or to achieve wind pollination, large amounts of pollen grains has to be released into the atmosphere. So here, out of the large thousands of pollen grains which are released into the atmosphere, there is a chance that so much pollen is becoming waste. Only one or two pollen, only one, it may attach here, so pollination may occur. Here, to compensate the loss of pollen grain, or to compensate this uncertainty, there is a chance of release of so many pollen grains. Out of these so many pollen grains, very few, or one or two, or especially one may, or it may not. So chance of occurrence, possibility, wind pollination or water. For example, water pollination. This is water body. In this water body, one female flower is here. In this is a water body. Male flowers may be there or may not be there. If male flowers are there, they have to release the pollen. That pollen has to come exactly to the female flower. Then only chances of pollination, fertilization. If it is not coming this side, if it is going that side through the water velocity, wind currents, there is no pollination. This is called chance of occurrence. Now, let us see wind pollination. Generally, wind pollination is seen in grasses. Grasses comes under family Poaceae, or old name of the family Graminaceae. Graminaceae. Poaceae. So what are the plants comes under this Poaceae or Graminaceae or grass family? Nothing but wheat, rice, maize, jowar, all these things, all the grasses, grass family generally. Now, sir, the plants which comes under grass family or Poaceae or Graminaceae, what are the characteristic features they possess for wind pollination, to facilitate wind pollination? Characteristic features. Characteristic features of wind pollinated plants. So, if plants are pollinating by wind, which is an abiotic agent, what characters they should possess? Generally, flowers are not attractive. Attractive means colors. So, flowers are not having any color, no color. Generally, flowers are small. Because if flowers are large, they will attract the other organism, something. But here, it is not organism, it is a wind. This is wind, abiotic agent. So there is no need of attracting the wind. Generally, flowers are not having any nectar or odor. No odor. O-D-O-U-R. Odor or nectarless. Or no fragrance. Smell. Nectar, odor. Fragrance comes only by this nectar or smell. Generally, they are not large, they are small. Flowers are small. If flowers are small, they cannot be seen. Generally, they were arranged in the form of groups of flowers. Small flowers, compactly, closely arranged in the form of inflorescence. It means small flowers means so many small flowers compactly arranged in the form of inflorescence. Characteristic features. So in CET and NEET, they may ask, one of the following is not the characteristic feature of anemophilous flowers. One of the following is the characteristic feature of wind pollinated plants. They may ask group of characters, identify from the above, which is correct about wind pollination. So many questions they can frame based upon the concept of the subject. Small flowers compactly arranged in the form of inflorescence. Generally, in a carpel, in the ovary, a single ovule is present. One ovary, one ovule. The androecium, in the androecium, stamens are long, freely exposed to the wind in the androecium, that is in the stamens. They are long, each and every stamen is long and freely exposed to the wind. What is freely exposed? The anther is freely exposed to the wind. When they were freely exposing to the wind, automatically when they mature, they can freely release the pollen grains into the atmosphere easily. Freely exposed to the wind, hence release pollen freely into the wind. So if they are not long, they will be are inside the petals or something, it is difficult to release the pollen grain. So they are, it is difficult to expose to the atmosphere. Pistils are long with feathery stigmas. So, in a flower, wind pollinated flower, the androecium or stamens are outside the flower exposed with their anthers, easy to release the pollen. In the same way, pistil stigma are also long, and generally these stigmas, they consist of feathers. Feather means they can attract and catch the pollen grains easily. To capture pollen from the air. So the main characteristic features, stamens and stigmas, both are stamens and pistils, carpels are long enough, protruding out of the flower, outside the flower, exposed to the atmosphere or wind or air, where they can liberate easily pollen. These pollen are taken by some other flower easily by the stigmas because of their feathery nature. Now, characteristic features of wind pollinated, most important characteristic features. Eighth one, these pollen which are liberated, after seventh one, eighth one, the pollen or pollen grains light in weight. So their weight is not heavy, they were light, because if they were light, they can be easily carried by wind. If they were heavy, they cannot carry it easily by wind. Sometimes wind may be having more velocity, wind may be having less velocity, they may fall off. The pollen light in weight for easy movement in air. The pollen non-sticky, sticky means attached to, adhered to, fixed to. Non-sticky means it cannot attach to, it cannot adhere to, it cannot fix. So what does it mean? How to understand this? When the pollen is released into the atmosphere, if the pollen is having stickiness, in the atmosphere so much amount of particulate matter is present. Small particles, micro particles, macro particles, various. If pollen is sticky, it will attach to the particulate matter, it may fall down or it may not reach to the proper stigma. So pollen grains, which are carried by wind, they are non-sticky. They are light in weight. Characteristic features. Non-sticky. So they cannot attach to any particulate matter, anything, any other object in this atmosphere, in the wind. Generally, so these are the concept, most important characteristic features of wind pollinated plants. Flowers are not attractive, no need of attraction to attract any organisms, because wind is the medium and they are small generally. It means why they were small? All our grass family, gas families, they were arranged in the form of what we call tillering, in the form of what we call inflorescence, in the form of what we call, example, corn cob are various grass plants where the inflorescence is like this compactly. So many small flowers are here, and these small flowers, they will produce something in the atmosphere like this. These pink structures are, pink and rounded structures are called stigma and pistil. These orange color structures are called androecium, anther. So they were emerged out from the compact arrangement. So this is the example of a grass plant inflorescence, or what we call bhutta or kanki. This is a tillered part, compactly arranged. So they were looking like tassels. Tassels means T-A-S-S-E-L-S, which is emerged out from the body, freely moving in the atmosphere so as to release the pollen and to catch the pollen. And flowers are not attractive. Flowers are not having large size. Flowers are not having any nectar or fragrance to attract. Small flowers compactly arranged. Why small flower cannot be seen? It is not conspicuous. Inconspicuous means it cannot be seen clearly. Oh, so when so many flowers are, it can be seen clearly. Small flowers compactly, a character which is related to pollination by insects. So they may ask questions, neat questions. Small flowers compactly arranged in the form of inflorescences. And these inflorescences appears like this. Now, single flower is having a single ovary with a single ovule. So each and every ovule will become a seed. In the androecium, stamens are long, exposed to the wind. In the pistils are long with feathery stigmas to capture the pollen from the light in weight, to carry movements, non-sticky, not to attach to anyone. Example, corn cob. So because of all this, it is easy for the pollen grain to move by wind. So wind is the pollinating agents, and each and every sentence, each and every character, they can ask like a question. And they can ask this as a 5-mark question or 3-mark, but any 3 important characters for wind pollination. One of the following is not the character of pollen grain. One of the following is the character of wind pollen. Wind pollinated plants, again, one of the following, they may ask all these, you have to remember this. One of the following is a character of wind pollinated plants, but it is not the character of pollen. Neat question. One of the four. So how many are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Out of these, the question is in the NEET. One of the following is a character of wind pollinated plant, but not the character of pollen. All are not the characteristic features of pollen. Characters of pollen are, pollen is light, non-sticky. One of the character is the character of only carpel. Carpel character. Pistils are long with feathery stigmas, one character. And generally, one ovule is present in. So, fifth and seventh are the characteristic features of stigmas. Neat question. One of the following is the characteristic feature of stamen, androecium or anther. Sixth point. The androecium stamens are long, exposed to the. In a wind pollinated plant, general question. In a wind pollinated plant, why androecium is exposed in the environment, into the atmosphere? To release pollen freely into the wind. So what is the reason why stigmas are having feathers? To catch the pollen. Because pollen are not sticky. If they were sticky, there is no need of feathery stigmas. Easily they can catch. So, in this pollination by wind or abiotic agent, so many questions are there. Now, it has moved to pollination by water. Water, which is a abiotic agent. So, water pollinated plants are rare. Water pollination is called hydrophily. Hydrophily. Water is a abiotic agent. Water pollinated plants are rare or less. Generally, water pollinated plants belongs to mostly monocots. Total about 30 genera which shows water pollination. So for about 30 genera genus are present in water pollination. In these 30 genera, most of the members belongs to monocots. They may ask question, CET question or NEET question. Out of the total 30 genera, maximum number are monocots. In angiosperms, in flowering plants. For example, water is the only pollinating agent in lower forms of plants. In lower forms of plant groups like algae, bryophytes, Pteridophytes. So in lower forms of plant groups like algae, bryophytes and pteridophytes, compulsorily these plant groups, they require water as their pollinating agent. Why, sir? They require water because they have to release gametes which will move in water to reach female gametes. So we have studied in the previous classes, that is in the first year PUC syllabus, algae which are living in the water, definitely they have to release the gametes into the water, and bryophytes and pteridophytes, which are considered as amphibians of the plant kingdom. Why they were considered as amphibians of the plant kingdom? Because bryophyte, if they want to complete their life cycle, they need water. Definitely without water they cannot complete their life cycle. What does it mean without water? When water is present, bryophytes will release their anthrozoites into the water. In the water, these anthrozoites will move here and there. Finally, they will reach to the archegonium. They will meet with the egg. It ensures the pollination and fertilization. In pteridophytes also, let us see these two, whether you have forgotten it or to recall. In bryophytes, the plant body of a moss plant is haploid gametophyte. So in bryophytes, if you want to see the pollination by water, haploid gametophyte, for example, this is the plant body, rhizoids, colloid leaf like structures, phylloids, and it will produce antheridia, jacketed sex organs, multicellular jacketed sex organs, antheridia. After some stage of its life, it will produce a branch also having colloid and phylloid spirally arranged leaves. It produces archegonia, multicellular jacketed sex organ, archegonia. Antheridia, archegonia on the same plant and on different branches, main and lateral branch. When they mature, they will release anthrozoid. When they are mature, they will form egg inside. So when they mature, when they release anthrozoid, when they will release and how anthrozoid will reach to archegonia and egg? It is facilitated by water. Whenever rain comes, any one droplet of water, if a droplet of water is here, droplet of water, one or two droplets, any water droplet falls, this facilitates breaking of the antheridia and it will produce anthrozoid. Anthro zooid, which is biflagellate. Anthrozooids are flagellated. So these anthrozooids move in this water, and finally they will reach to Archegonia. Inside the Archegonia, egg is present. Egg, egg cell, female gamete. Male gamete is anthrozooid, female gamete is egg. Pollination by water. So compulsorily, if water is not there, there is no chance of pollination in bryophytes. In the same way, pollination in pteridophytes, pollination in pteridophytes, it also requires, this is the soil, to this soil, the gametophyte or prothallus, which is called haploid gametophyte of pteridophytes. In pteridophytes, prothallus or gametophyte is heart shaped like this. It is attached to the soil like this. When it is attached to the soil with the help of rhizoids, at this place it is having Antheridia, at this place it is having Archegonia. Antheridia, which are called male. Archegonia, female. But the movement of anthrozooid from here to this, unless water is not there, it is not possible. So water is required for the transfer of male anthrozooids from the Antheridia to the Archegonia. Whenever rainwater comes, in the rainwater it will liberate the anthrozooid. And this anthrozooid move to the Archegonia or female. So water is a compulsory media for the transfer of male gametes in lower forms of plants like algae and bryophytes. And this is the reason why we cannot find bryophytes and pteridophytes everywhere. It means the geographical distribution of bryophytes and pteridophytes is restricted to some areas only. What does it mean? The geographical distribution of bryophytes and pteridophytes is restricted to some areas wherever water is available. If water is not there, no chance of pollination. Let us see in angiosperms how water pollination occurs in the coming classes. So in the page number 30, 28, 29, 30, if you see clearly, you can see numerous number of each and every statement could be asked, can be asked like a single CET or NEET questions. All the best.